Well, guys, we're on week 3 of quarantine now, and all I really have to say is that I'm never putting off a haircut again. All right, I hope any of you who are stuck at home right now are having a ton of fun watching movies and playing video games. We actually have a lot to play right now between Doom Eternal, Half-Life Alyx, Animal Crossing New Horizons, and then Resident Evil 3's remake comes out this Friday. It's a pretty stacked release schedule right now, and on top of all of that, we have a pretty big Halloween update that I was not expecting so soon. All right, so over on Twitter, Jason Blum sent out a tweet, which was basically a document, I guess letter, saying, "Sorry everyone, 2020 is canceled. We all worked really hard, but so far, it's been kind of a disaster, so we're just going to cancel it and move on to 2021. Now, for some reason, a lot of people took that as him saying all of the Blumhouse movies that are scheduled are now delayed to 2021, but no, it is a joke. Do not worry, everyone. Everything is fine. Anyway, someone responded to the tweet saying, "Or you could release the Halloween Kills trailer and make us all happy." But this time, instead of ignoring it or just giving it a heart like he usually does, Jason responded and he said, "We are tweaking it. I'll tell you something, it's looking really good. Soon." Obviously, a statement like that is interesting to me for a few reasons. The first one being that it kind of gives us an answer to whether or not Halloween Kills is delayed, and thankfully for right now, it looks like the answer is no. I mean, think about it. If Blumhouse and Universal were planning on delaying the movie anytime soon, there is no way in hell they'd even be considering, let alone talking about, releasing the trailer for it soon. I'm sure they know this, but you only get one chance to get people really excited with the trailer, and you definitely can't release it too early. What I mean by that is, even though there's already a built-in fan base for Halloween Kills of basically lifelong Halloween fans and people who went out to see Halloween 2018 and want to see where that story goes, if they show the trailer too early, it's going to be really hard to sustain the hype they have all the way until 2021 if they do plan on delaying the movie. That's like kind of impossible if you ask me. With everything that's going on in the world right now, I don't think it really even needs to be said, but all of this is subject to change. With that being said though, I feel like they're pretty confident that this will all be wrapped up by October and we'll actually be able to go to the movie theater again. I mean, they have to be pretty confident in that fact if they are even planning on releasing that trailer anytime soon, and they're already talking about it. So I feel like at least for now, if things keep trending how they are, we'll be okay to see the movie in theaters by October, but if things somehow get worse, then that's when we have to start worrying. It's basically the same way I felt in my last video, if you guys caught that. I also think it's interesting that they're still tweaking the trailer, because one of the biggest complaints a lot of people had with Halloween 2018, and honestly, this is a complaint I share, is that between the teaser, the trailer, the international trailer, the scenes that came out before the movie, the convention stuff, there was just way too much of the movie shown by the time it came out. It honestly felt like we knew everything that was going to happen in Halloween 2018, and there were very few surprises left up to the movie to actually deliver if you watched everything that came out. And with all the hype that was building for Halloween 2018, I know the vast majority of fans did watch everything that was released. So it's not really Blumhouse's fault or Universal's fault because people made the decision to watch those trailers, but honestly, I feel like they could have guessed the hype on that a little bit and just been a little bit more careful to reuse footage or make sure they weren't showing critical moments. Like, we all knew that Vicky was going to die very early in the movie based on the first teaser alone, I'm pretty sure, if I'm remembering right, you know? And that was just for Halloween 2018. Now that we're talking about Halloween Kills, we also have the context of the Black Christmas trailer and the Invisible Man trailer showing pretty much the entirety of both of those two movies. It's basically becoming a trend for Blumhouse right now, and there are a lot of people out there who don't like it. Honestly, it doesn't always bother me when you know what's going to happen in a movie, if you know some of the key critical moments, because that's really what gets me excited to go see it sometimes. I see a lot of movies and they all kind of like blend together after a while, but sometimes you see a trailer where something really cool happens, like in the Invisible Man trailer when Cecilia knocks the paint off onto the suit and you can kind of see the Invisible Man. That was a really cool moment that I guess would have been cool to not have spoiled, but it really is the one that made me go, oh, I need to see this movie. But like I mentioned, other people get upset about this and they tweet at Jason Blum all the time, and he's responded a couple times, and the gist of it is that in his opinion, all of the movies we have available to watch at home on Netflix and Disney Plus and Hulu and HBO Go, all of that is stuff they have to compete with their marketing. So they have to say, all right guys, we got to convince you by showing you as much as we can to go out and spend money money on a movie ticket and see our movie in the theaters, because that's where people like Jason Blum make their money. They don't make their money off of streaming. But there is a not so small group of people who are upset about how much trailers show, and they tweet at Jason Blum all the time, which got him responding to a few people back in January. And the gist of it is that the reason they show so much in their trailers is because they're competing with streaming services like Netflix and Amazon and Hulu, HBO Go, and Disney Plus. All of these services are releasing original movies, and you can watch those in the comfort of your home. So they have to show you as much as possible in the trailers for these theatrical movies because they want you to be compelled to go out and buy a ticket, because it's hard to convince people to leave their house. So they say, hey, we're gonna show you the most compelling stuff from this movie so you'll spend your money. And honestly, I think he's both right and wrong, but I'll get into that a little bit more in a second. The reason in part I kind of think he's wrong is because for hardcore horror fans like me, or probably you if you're watching this video, if Universal and Blumhouse have their name on probably an R-rated horror movie, we're not talking about the PG-13 ones here, a lot of us are already committed to going to see it. So when we check out the trailer to get excited for what we're going to see in a few months, and giant, massive spoilers are hidden throughout the entire thing, that upsets us, and I honestly feel like that's warranted. But of course, the easy argument there is if you already know you're going to see the movie in theaters, don't watch the trailer because there's probably going to be spoilers in it and you already want to see the movie, so the trailer isn't really necessary to get you excited. But if there's a movie you need to be convinced to go see, like Black Christmas, it can work out in the positive because that movie's trailer showed the entire thing from start to finish and it looked horrible in the trailer, and lo and behold, the movie turned out to be just as bad as the trailer. If they're putting all of the movie's best moments in the trailer to get you excited to see it and that doesn't look very good, then you can make a fair judgment on whether or not you need to go and spend 20 bucks to watch a movie. I mean, after watching the Black Christmas trailer, I made the educated guess that it wouldn't even be worth using my A-list on it. Now that I've seen it at home, boy was I right. The other side of the coin though, basically where I think he's right, is that the general moviegoer, not the hardcore horror fan, needs to be convinced that it's worth going out to the movie theater and spending 15 bucks on a ticket, spending money on gas, and spending money on concessions. So that's why I feel like it is a little bit warranted to put some cool moments in trailers. Like when the average person hears that a new Halloween movie is coming out, they're thinking of Michael Myers killing someone with a knife. So that's exactly what you need to put in the trailer to reassure them so that they'll go spend money on a ticket. That's exactly what they didn't do with Halloween 3, and look what happened. That movie made nothing despite the fact that it's pretty awesome. And really, I was surprised with the comments on my last video because I expected the vast majority of you to say that you didn't care if theaters open back up or not and you just want to watch Halloween Kills at home. But that really wasn't the case. Like the overwhelming majority said that they want theaters to open up and they can't imagine not seeing Halloween Kills on the big screen. You know what? Made me feel pretty good. I really do think there's a value of seeing a movie on a big screen in complete darkness with amazing speakers and great visual quality in a room where no one can talk to you and you can't look at your phone. All you can really do is sit there and watch the movie, and if a theater is good, if you do anything other than that, they're gonna kick you out. And if I'm a filmmaker who's putting all this time and energy into making a movie, because making a movie is extremely hard, I want people to see it for the first time in the best way possible, with a big, huge screen that's crystal clear and has amazing sound. It's just something you can't get at home, and I don't really feel like that's an argument, because you have to be super rich to build a theater in your house and get movies early. So the real question here is, when are we going to get to see this trailer? Because soon doesn't really tell us much, and every Blumhouse movie has been pulled from theaters for the time being, so there's nothing they could attach it to over the next couple months. In fact, if you take a look at all the movies that Blumhouse was supposed to release in 2020, the next one that Halloween Kills trailer could theoretically be attached to is Purge, which comes out at the beginning of July. And in my opinion, Soon definitely doesn't cover a 4-month wait. So as much as it sucks, I don't really feel like there's an answer to this question. We basically have to sit and be patient for them to drop it online, because I feel like that's where it's going to end up. But if you really want to see the Halloween trailer as soon as it drops, I would recommend following Ryan Turek on Twitter and crossing your fingers you start seeing some pumpkins and knives on that page, because that's when things were about to start happening with Halloween 2018, and I feel like it's fair to assume that that's how things are going to happen again with Halloween Kills. Real quick, before I wrap this video up, I wanted to let you guys know that I've been streaming video games here on my channel because I suddenly, like many people out there, have an abundance of free time. I basically just do Q&As where people can ask me whatever they want about what movies I want to see or any horror movies I've seen in the past, and we've also been going over my videos like the Terrifier review I just did, which in my opinion is incredible. So if you want to see my next live stream, make sure your notifications are turned turned on. And if you haven't checked in a while, make sure you click it and set them to all notifications. So the next time I go live, you'll get a buzz on your phone and in your email. Anyway, guys, I think that about covers it. So as always, my name is Jimmy Champagne, and I'll see you in the next one. Shape on.